Welcome to you, artist, and thank you very much for staying with me in my Krita beginner's tutorial. In today's episode, we are going to talk about layers in digital art. We will check what layers are and how do they work. Later, we will look at layer types and blending modes as well. We will talk about the alpha channel and we are going to look at some neat tricks. Let's see, what are layers? Layers are just simply stuck transparent paper on the top of each other and you can do different operations on them. Layers in Krita can be managed simply in the layer menu, or you can use the layers docker for operating on these layers. To create a new one, just simply click on the plus. You can highlight multiple layers and you can create a group of them with the right click and using the group quick group option. If you don't like the order of the layers, you can simply reorder them. Just simply grab it and put it anywhere else. There are different types of layer you can create in Krita. The most basic is the paint layer on which you can do the actual painting. You can create different layers with this little drop-down menu, and here you can see all of the layer types you can use. We are not going to run through them, but you can use the Krita documentation to check them. I have been asked by beginner artists whether is it necessary to use layers in digital art, and the answer is simply no, it's not necessary. Just think about the traditional media. You can create beautiful art without using layers. So, just as a little recap, let's just take a look at what can we do with these layers. We can create new layers with the plus button. We can move them around here in the layer stack. And we can create groups of the layers, if we want to do so, with the right click, group and quick group. What else can we do with them? Layers have a property called blending mode and it sets the relation between the layers on the top of each other. I used to use the multiply and the overlay layer modes for my paintings. We are not going to check all of layer modes in Krita, but these two, in my opinion, are very interesting for beginner students. If I want to paint shadows in digital art, then I use the multiply layer, because this blending mode will simply take the pixel and multiply it with the pixel beneath, and it will cause always a darker color. I paint shadows simply. I created this funny looking abstract box here, and if I want to create some shadow on it, then I will create a layer on the top of it and I will set it to multiply. I like to use cool colors for the start, so I will look here. Let's see, if I paint it, you can see it takes the color beneath the new layer and creates a darker tone of that color multiplied by the color I'm painting actually now. When I want to paint light in digital art, then I use the screen blending mode. I do it with simply creating another layer on the top and set it to screen. It is exactly the reverse of the multiply. It will screen up or lighten up the pixels beneath. As you can see, I can choose a lighter color for it. I just drop down the opacity a bit and you see it lightens up the pixels beneath. So I'm actually painting light. Please note that I put these layers outside of a group, because when I put them into a group, then the layer mode will be changed. You see that? It happened because the layer mode of the group took precedence. But you can override it with this pass-through mode icon. And voila, you see the blending modes are the individual blending modes of the layers. Or if you want to, you can create a blending mode for the group as well. And voila, the whole group is multiply blending mode now. With a little knowledge of the alpha channel, you can paint only on the already painted areas of the canvas. But what is alpha channel? It's simply the transparency. So you can only paint on those parts of the canvas where you already have painted something. Why is it important for us? I create a new layer again, put it on the top of the layer stack and paint here something with some stronger color. If I want to paint only on this area, then I can simply use the alpha lock. And let's say I want to make red some parts of this, then I simply lock the alpha, and now if I want to paint, I can only paint on the already painted part, because all the transparent parts are locked. This means alpha lock. We can achieve the same result with clipping groups in an undestructive way. It means that if I want to create a painting where I paint something and I do not want to lock the alpha channel, I paint on it, but I want to paint on a different layer, then I can right click on the layer and use the group again. But instead of the quick group, I use the clipping group, which will create this group system. Then I can simply paint on the top of this layer, on the top of the painting, without destroying the original one. You see, it is untouched. If I use the alpha lock, then I am actually painting on the already painted area, so I kind of destroy it. Holy moly, I forgot one of the most important buttons on this layer docker. How can we delete layers or groups? With this icon, we can simply delete any kind of layers we want. Thank you for watching this part of my Krita Basics tutorial. If you like the video, just don't forget to subscribe and please drop me a like. See you in the next episode. Thank you.